Welcome back to our English grammar class, and in today's session we are going to learn about negator, modal, verbs and contraction. So what is the today's title? Negator, modal, verbs and contraction of modal verbs. In our previous session we have learned what is a modal verbs. What is modal verbs? Modal verbs are group of auxiliary verbs. I repeat it again. Modal verbs are group of auxiliary verbs. There are 13 modal verbs in our English grammar, but to our syllabus there are only 12 modal verbs. But remember it, there are 13 modal verbs in our English grammar. Okay, now coming to the today's session. Today we are going to learn about negative modal verbs. Negated is nothing but the negative form of modal verbs, and to the contraction of modal verbs. You can ask me, why is it so important or why is it so necessary to learn the negated or the negative form of modal verbs? I can tell you your reply that, for example, as a human being, we are all human beings, right? As a human being, we have two thoughts. What are they? One is positive thoughts and the other one is negative thoughts. So two thoughts, one is positive and the other one is negative. So if you are going to start a work, okay, if you are going to start a work, you have both the thoughts, right? For example, you can think, first we can take the positive thought. You think that I can do this work, okay? I can do this work and I will receive recognition or appreciation from everyone in the class or everyone in the office likewise. So this is one of the positive thoughts our mind will have when you are going to start a work. Whereas negative thought, this is the second one, okay? The negative thought is nothing but you think that what happens if I do something wrong in this work. Everyone will curse me, everyone will blame me. So this is another type of thinking of mind that is full of negative thoughts. But we have to lead our life by following the way of positive thoughts. It only helps you to success or succeed in your life. Okay, so just follow the positive thoughts in your life. Just leave it the negative thoughts. Of course it comes in your mind, but take as my advice, okay? This is my simple advice to you all, that just follow the positive way of life, okay? Now coming to this class, okay? This is a simple advice and it is related to our session, okay? See the negative modal verbs. In the same way, we have already know the positive form of modal verbs. And it is necessary, okay? It is necessary to know the negative form as well. Why? Because, for example, take the first word can. We can use can for possibility, for suggestion, for ability, etc. You know that, because it are the main, these are the meanings of modal verbs. So if you take it as positive thoughts, we can say that I can lift 10 kilograms of weight. So this is one of the positive thought, okay? I can lift 10 kilograms of weight. Whereas why it is necessary to learn a negative form? See here, in the same way, if you are given more than 10 kilograms of weight, what can you do? You can't able to lift it, right? So you tell that I cannot lift more than 10 kilograms of weight. So in positive form, you say that I can lift 10 kilograms of weight, whereas in negative form you say that I cannot lift more than 10 kilograms of weight. Here I cannot is a negative form or negation form of modal verbs. Now coming to the third form, here I have written a third form which is nothing but contraction. What do you mean by contraction? Contraction is nothing but making things smaller. Okay, here if you are writing a big paragraph, you have to make it a smaller, then you can tell it as contraction. Okay, so how will you contract the same negative forms into this Instead of saying cannot, you can say it as I can't. So can is nothing but the contraction form of negated modal verbs. So here, now coming to our session, see here. First, see the modal verbs. Here I have written only 12 modal verbs because it is in our syllabus, right? But there are 13 modal verbs in our English grammar. Here I have differentiated. Okay, 9 modal verbs in different color, as well as the remaining 3 modal verbs in different color. You can ask me why, but there is a reason. What is that? These 9 modal verbs are known as pure modals, whereas these 3 modals are known as semi modals or marginal modals. See, you know that modal verbs is different, distinguished into 2 types. Okay, one is pure modal and the other one is semi modal or marginal modal. These 9 are known as pure modal, whereas these 3 are known as semi modal or marginal modal. Clear? Okay. Now we will see the negative form of these modal verbs. How will you write in the negative form? It is very simple. We are just adding the word not after the positive form of modal verbs. Take the first thing, word can. How will you write it in the negative form? Can plus not, cannot. Okay? For example, we can say I can do it. In the negative form, you can say, I cannot do it. So, this is the basic difference between can, I mean the positive form and as well as the negative form. Okay, I can do it and I cannot do it. Now, coming to the second one, could. How will you write the could? By just simple, for everything you have to add only not, could not. Okay, coming to the third modal verb, shall. It can be written as shall not. Okay? I shall do this. I shall not do this. This is the basic difference between the positive as well as negative form of modal verbs. Now coming to the fourth, should. It can be written as should plus not, should not. Next, will. It can be written as will not. Next, would. Can be written as would plus not, would not. Whereas may, it can be written as may not. Next modal verb is might. In the negative form, it is might not. Next must, and it in the negative form, must not. So these are the pure modals, and it can be written in the negative form as in this way. Whereas, do you have any difference between the pure modals and semi modals in negative form? No. As we had in not after the pure modals, in the same way we have to add not after the semi modals. Okay? The basic difference between them is only in positive form. In what situation we are using these words in a sentence. Okay, whereas the negative form are all same to both pure modals and the semi modals or marginal modals. Dare, it can be written as dare not. Okay, next need, need not. Next, ought to. Here you have a confusion, right? Here I have to add not. In between the letters or after the to, but you won't confuse about it because you have to add not in between them. Ought not to, it is a right form. Okay, don't add not after the to, you have to add the not in between ought and to. So these are the negative form or the negative modal verbs, which are often known as negated modal verbs. We use these negative forms in a sentence to show the negative meaning. Okay? To show the negative meaning. Now coming to the third one. Third one, what is that? Contraction. I have already said that what do you mean by contraction? Contraction is nothing but make things smaller. Making things smaller. Here, what things we are making smaller? We are making the modal verbs into a short form. Okay? How will you write it? The negative form of cannot can be written in the contracted form as can apostrophe T. You can see these words in many textbooks. Even we also write this in our sentences. So this is, we can say it as the contraction form of modal verbs. Okay? Cannot, it can be written in the contracted form as can't. Okay? Can't. Next, could not. How will you write this? In the same way you have to write. By putting the apostrophe in between them. Okay? Could not, couldn't. Whereas shall not. How will you write this? Shall not can be written as shan't. Okay? See the difference here. I am not writing as it is. Shall not can be written it as shan't. Next, shouldn't. Should not can be written as should n apostrophe t. Clear? Now coming to the will not. How will you write the will not? In the same way as we written shan't, we have to write will not as won't. Okay? We have to write it as won't. Next, would not. Would n apostrophe t. Next, may not and might not. This both do not have the contraction form. Wherever you use the negative form in a sentence, you have to write as it is like may not or might not. Because these two words do not have the contraction form in the modal verbs. Clear? Now coming to the next one, must not. In the same way you have to write, putting the apostrophe. Okay? Next, dare not. Even to dare not, we do not have the contraction form. As I said earlier, may not, might not and dare not in the modal verbs, they do not have any contraction form. Next, need not. How will you write need not? Need, n, apostrophe, t. Next, the last one. Here, again, you will have a confusion that how will you contract this ought not to. It is very simple. See here, ought, n, apostrophe, t, to. So, these are the contraction form of modal verbs. So, in this session, we have learnt, okay, the positive form of modal verbs, that there are 12 modal verbs in our syllabus. And for that 12 modal verbs, we have learned how to write the negative form of modal verbs by simply adding the not after that. Okay? And we learned the contraction form of modal verbs. And for the three words, that is may, might, dare, we do not have any contraction form. Is it clear? Okay. In this session, we learned about the modal verbs, that is the negative and the contraction form of modal verbs. And in our next session, we will deal with another interesting topic. Be happy like the smileys here. Thank you for watching.